Hey guys, it's me, Zell, and we are here with the next episode of Mandalorian Season 3. We're going to be watching the second to last episode of this season, Episode 7, aka Chapter 23, titled The Spies. We're going to get right back into the action, I imagine, last episode. It's kind of, as people like to call it, filler. I enjoyed it. It was kind of a nice reprieve before some more intense... Actually, it was kind of sandwiched between some intense action fighting stuff. So I think it added to the variety of the Star Wars universe and gives us an idea a little bit where these mercenaries, Mandalorian mercenaries that Bo-Katan was seeking out to join back up with the other Mandalorians so they can come back as a people instead of being scattered amongst the galaxy, which was requested the armorer Bo-Katan to seek these out, and she did, and there was quite a lot of them, so I'll be interested to see them come together, imagining that is going to happen. Now, I don't know what the spies means. Perhaps within this mercenary group, there are some two-faced individuals working on double two sides. I'm not sure. Maybe that's what they're getting at. Or spies within the city they're going to inhabit. Who knows? But I imagine we're going to get back into it. There's only two more episodes left of the season, and they're going to want to set us up for the following Mandalorian season or into other shows. I'm not sure. So we'll just get back to it and we'll see what's in store. So let's get to it. Episode 7, Spies. Cyberpunk City. Is this the underbelly of Coruscant, or is this a different planet? Yeah, I knew it was her. Wow. You're giving information to a probe?
Report. And make it quick, as I am short on time.
Wow, there he
Sir,
is.
I'm afraid the pirates have run into trouble on Navarre. Magistrate Cargo was aided by Mandalorians.
Which Mandalorians?
According to the reports received by the New Republic.
Wow.
Bo-Katan Kryze led a squadron of Mandalorians.
I shall deal with our Mandalorian friends.
Oh. Whoa. Dude never gives up. You're that dedicated to the Empire.
We must be cautious and show no sign of our true strength. The New Republic will increase their efforts to hunt us down.
There are citizens loyal to the Empire on every planet in this galaxy. They're already getting sick of this New Republic.
Grand Admiral Thrawn's return will herald in the reemergence of our military and provide Commandant Hux enough time to deliver on Project Necromancer.
Captain Pelion, once again. That Grand Admiral Thrawn is missing.
Why is his suit so special compared to them?
Any word on when he will be able to participate in the Shadow Council? I hear whispers from one end of the galaxy to another, and never a word of Thrawn. Perhaps it's time we look to new leadership.
Oh,
yeah.
The creation of clones is your obsession, not mine.
Mm-hmm,
I account
really?
For what goes on in my sector. No more,
you
no less.
You received your request. 3 Praetorian guards. Sounds like someone is concerned about an assassination attempt.
This is so intriguing.
That they are preparing to retake their home world of Mandalore. We shall be rid of the Mandalorians once and for all. Long live the Empire!
Oh,
Long
no.
live the Empire!
Here comes their big old ship. That's good for the prosperity of their city, you know? Be nice, guys. I thought they didn't wear helmets, or maybe they changed policy. Oh! Where's their armor?
Welcome, fellow Mandalorians. We invite you to make camp. Let us prepare.
I don't know why this makes me emotional. She did as she was requested. She brought them together. Already getting into the Oh my gosh, he's working it.
His memory circuit. The pilot provides cognition.
Yes.
Yes.
Bad baby. No, let's go in.
Well.
Wait, is Grogu supposed to drive it?
No. But let's see if he fits.
Oh, I thought the Anzillion was gonna. Little sounds, the baby sounds he makes.
So what do you think?
Heavy machinery. Maybe when he's older.
No.
What do you mean, no?
No.
Oh. I think he's saying he's old enough to operate it.
Yes.
There.
No.
No, at least let him try it out in my office.
Yes.
No, this is not a good idea. Hey.
Oh my god, he's just a little brat! He's getting the terrible twos!
Yes, 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 yes.
Oh my
yes.
god.
Yes. Yes.
That's
yes.
gonna be so.
Yes, 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 yes. yes.
Okay, yes. that's yes. enough, Grogu.
Yes, yes.
No.
Yes.
Hey, Grogu, no. Give it no. Grogu, give it back.
Damn.
I will go. Grogu as well.
I will go.
I will go.
Wow.
I will go as well.
Really?
Scouting party descending to surface.
Makes me sad. They're all like, this was many of their homes. This was their home planet. Don't you dare hurt the baby. Look how happy she is. This was her dream and she's getting to do it. She's leading Mandalorians to reclaim Mandalore. Is that a ship?
Night Owls.
Flanking left.
Is it pirates? So there are like...
Do you have food?
We do?
Question mark?
Is that the voice of Lady Bo-Katan Kryze?
Who is that? I didn't recognize the voice right away.
We knew you would not forsake us, Lady Bo-Katan.
Oh, there's other Mandalorians on there.
They intercepted any ships they saw leaving. They took no prisoners.
They've been there that whole time.
They punished us, refused to surrender.
That's not true. I did surrender. I met with Moff Gideon. The ISB had reached out to me to negotiate a ceasefire. I didn't trust him, but it was the only chance I had to save our people.
So he just straight up didn't.
And then he betrayed me, and we were helpless to resist the Purge of Mandalore.
Bro, how'd she be looking so young?
Your song is not yet written. I will serve you until it is.
Whoa, he knows that game well.
You can't move an enforcer like that.
The enforcer moves like a wing guard when it's flanking.
These primitives make up their own rules for everything.
A vibro raid?
submit or fight.
Is that how these games typically go?
It was bound to happen sooner or later.
Poor Axe, he can't lose twice in a row, but I don't want our bro to lose either. Yeah, that guy's a big bro, I don't know. Oh!
No. 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 No.
You taught your apprentice well.
You didn't learn that from me.
Aww. Is it a worm? A creature? Is it the Mistensaur? It's a rock dragon? It's a giant lizard? Godzilla! Are we literally just gonna walk right by it? That's cool. Oh no.
This is what's left of the Great Forge. This was once the heart of our civilization.
Jetpacks.
Nope.
Those aren't Mandalorians.
Take cover.
So are those all bots though? Because we saw them just standing there. We could just shoot. Oh my gosh. Oh, Beskar armor. So it probably... Yeah, do that and sling him around. Wait, is this an Imperial cave? I don't know if you should trust where they're leading you guys. Oh no! Do not, it can't hurt then.
I have created the next generation dark trooper suit, forged from Beskar. And the most impressive improvement is that it has me in it. Why don't we take your fleet off the board while we still have the element of surprise?
No!
Activate the interceptors and bombers.
No!
I'll cover the rear!
No. We're not leaving you behind!
Go! There are too many.
No!
This is the way.
Bro, he's gonna be okay. Bro, there's two left. You can do it. No, I don't like that. I guess we've been spoiled with not a lot of loot loss of people. I don't know why he let Din survive, because he has a history with him. And he, wasn't it sad? It's hard when I feel this way to be like, that was a great episode, you know? I mean, it was a good episode, but my heart is breaking It was a lot of sad stuff. Obviously, it was cool to see them finally come together. And as we suspected, there'd be a little bit of animosity, a little bit of conflict and awkwardness. But we saw them work through it in their own way and come together for the uniting cause of reclaiming Mandalore. And we obviously knew it wouldn't come without its headaches and its difficulties. But I was not suspecting Imperial takeover. It makes more sense now, everything about that, and how he's like, nay, you guys can't exist cohesively with us, because one, it kind of conflicts with his idea, and he's like, and also, not that he would probably feel this way, but, you know, shown up that we know that they are better fighters. I mean, Paz just took out swaths of people as one single individual. You know, it wasn't until, and he was outnumbered that whole time, but it wasn't until he ran out of his ammo and his gun, and then they brought out their stupid swords that I'm forgetting the name of. But a lot of conflict in my heart, you know. Din got separated and he fought as much as he could, and then he got taken away. Paz was murdered and the others escaped, but not say we didn't see it yet, but he was sending bombers to the fleet with the armor and all the sick and all the other Mandalorians, just not in the scouting. And the whole time they can't communicate because of the freaking block signal, so they can't even send a warning. So it's just really hard, which makes me wonder if he was having his meeting that whole time. He clearly has some sort of communication that he's worked out to get past, but if he's been there a while and he has his whole base set up, he definitely has something to get past it. So that could potentially be something that they get hold of, some sort of communication device. I think it's beyond them sending a warning, because I'm pretty sure they'll see once the bombers come, they're like, oop, they can fight them off. I'm not worried that they're going to completely obliterate it. It's not like Death Star lasers, right? Yeah, and that big old beast was cool. The hammer-tailed lizard. Ginormous. We only saw just a little sneak peek of it, but it was pretty cool. Definitely gave, like, that Godzilla vibes, or gave a little bit of the Cloverfield vibes, because I feel like you didn't see the whole thing. It was just the fear of it being there. Really cool hearing that history, the backstory from Bo about her last minute. She did surrender. She did give up. That's how he got a hold of the Darksaber. It wasn't in combat. It was her giving it over in order to save her people. And then he betrayed her and he still killed all of her people. That's just heartbreaking. Was nice to see at least there were some that survived. How many got out in the end? You know, they obviously had some more losses. So yeah, there's the spy. Gideon's, you know, and what other plans, what other of her mission is there? It's just to keep everything about his base hush-hush, everything in that regard. He makes it sound like there's an end. And there's a long con game he's playing. I can't tell if he is caring about cloning or not. It sounds like not. It sounds like he's just obsessed with doing this new Mandalorian thing. Now, who are these Imperial? Who are these individuals within these suits, within this Beskar armor? Is he saying that these are clones of himself? In which case, I'm like, dude, he ain't that great of a fighter. They took out quite a few of you. Now, you could play the numbers game. The clones were aplenty, and they were good fighters, and obviously they got taken out in some capacity. Circumstances, things happen. Just statistics happen. But that's what makes me curious. What's he saying? And now, he's like, and it lives in me. I mean, he dabbled in cloning a bit, obviously. But I'm just curious about, are those just other people? People from the Imperial Army, people who enlisted that are in the suits he's donning? Was that, or is there more to it? And he is suggesting these are clones of himself. Curiosity. I don't know. But hopefully we'll get kind of answers about that. I imagine maybe in the debriefing room we will. Oh yeah, and then at least they gave us this lighthearted moment. Now granted, it was at the beginning before all this conflict, but little turd, little terrible two toddler Grogu. No. Yeah, and he's just using it and Din's like, I don't like this. I don't blame you, bro. Now he's probably not gonna get much bigger, but that's what he would do if he was like that taller. He would have totally done that. And the curious thing is do you think if Grogu had access to say like a translator box, would he be able to communicate fully? Now, physically, he's not communicating words, but clearly he's able to through his mind with Ahsoka through the Force. But it just gave me the idea that no, yes, no, yes. Reminds me of those dogs who push those buttons and they're trained on it. Yeah. That whole beginning gave me good feels, and then I ended in bad feels. So that's where this mixed feelings is coming from. It doesn't take away, per se, from how good the episode was and all this yumminess we got. And also about them being on Concordia. Are they suggesting that Concordia, that the Death Watch was the only folks that were up on Concordia, and that these individuals, these extremists or what have you, came from the Death Watch, which has broken apart and had war with each other? Or are they suggesting they were a different tribe amongst on that planet? I can't recall. Heartbreaking nonetheless. Overall, a good episode. We have one more episode left. We have to get some sort of conclusion. Somehow we have this other small scouting party that remains. Are they going to try to rescue Din? Jin? Are they going to have a small group of them do that? I imagine Grogu is going to be adamant about that. Are they going to try to get back to the ship's gone. They have zero ship, right? They all took one ship down there. Maybe steal a ship to try or get to the communication and communicate to their fleet. Are they just going to go in and try to destroy their plans? I don't know. There's a handful of options, but reclaiming Mandalore is not working as expected. It's, you know, one thing to deal with like pirates or wild people or animals, but to deal with the Empire and a base that has been built there and disrespecting their Beskar and taking it for themselves. Yeah, we have a lot to deal with and mostly get through. But anyways, that's enough about that. I apparently can go on, but guys, thanks so much for being here and watching. If you've made it this far, congrats. Thank you, welcome. If you haven't already, give that video a thumbs up and like it. And if you also are not a subscriber yet, go ahead and push that subscribe button. That'll let you know when the video goes live and you can check it out as soon as that happens. But yeah, guys, anyways, thanks again. I hope you're all well. Stay healthy. Enjoy some sunshine. And I will see you on the next one.